For this project, we're going to recreate this cats versus dogs infographic. And on the screen, you can see the entire infographic, which is quite long. This is the infographic viewed at 100% size. The infographic is designed for placement on a web page. So this is 1,000 pixels wide and would be displayed either at 100% or somewhat smaller, maybe 80 or 90%. One thing we want to keep in mind is that when viewing the infographic at 100% size or close to it, it's meant to be scrolled through. So the entire infographic does not fit on the screen at once, just portions of it. So that way the viewer can just focus on certain information and isn't overwhelmed by the entire thing. Something that is very important to keep in mind when designing an infographic like this is that we want to make sure that we make our text an appropriate size. We want to make sure, especially, that our body text is normal, comfortable reading size. The body text on this page is 14 points, which is on the larger side of body text for most documents. So we can use our body text as a reference point to ensure that we maintain a good typographic hierarchy. So if the body text is 14 points, that leaves us room to go a little bit smaller. The source text here is 12 points, and it leaves us room to go larger for things like titles of our different graphs. The title of our infographic is very large and is treated more as a logotype or a graphic than regular text. So let's begin working on recreating our infographic. I've already figured out the parameters for this, so I'm going to be referring to those while we work on the project. First thing we need to do is go into Illustrator, and we want to create a new document. And let's choose web, and make sure that our units are at pixels, and we want our document to be 1,000 pixels wide by 2,780 pixels high. We can leave everything else alone and choose create. Let's save our document right away. I'm not going to save it into my resources folder, but I'll save it into my project folder. And you'll name yours appropriately for the project. Before we begin, we should just reset the essentials. So let's go to Reset Essentials, and we can close up these windows, and I'm going to move these buttons down here just to maximize my workspace. Let's bring out our Layers window, and let's name the first layer Background. And on this layer, we can create a background, so I'm going to choose my Rectangle tool. And I'm going to double-click with the rectangle tool and choose a width of 1,000 pixels and a height of 2,780 pixels. Choose OK. I'm going to make sure under the View menu that Snap to Point is selected, but Snap to Pixels is not. So we also don't want Snap to Grid selected, just Snap to Point. I'm going to move this into position. And I'm going to choose a fill color. So for my fill color, I'm going to double click on the fill swatch. And I'm going to type in the color, which is FFEEBD. I want to just make sure that my background is placed so that it's flush to the edge. And what's happening is that I have a stroke applied to this. So I want to remove that stroke. So I'm just going to choose the drop-down menu for the stroke swatch and choose this none, which is the red horizontal line. And then I'm going to go ahead and align my background with the edge of my document. I'm going to lock this background so I don't accidentally move it. So I'm going to unfold this background layer, and for this rectangle object, I'm going to choose lock. I'm going to use guides to define the margins of our document. So first I'm going to go to the view menu and choose rulers and show rulers. And then I'm going to zoom in. And I want to note that on these rulers that each one of these tick marks represents 10 pixels. I want the top and the side margins of my document to be 30 pixels wide. So I'm going to drag out guidelines from these rulers using the tick marks as guides so that I place them at 30 pixels from the edge of the document. So I counted 1, 2, 3. I'm going to do that same thing for the sides. And then I'm going to go down to the bottom. And I'm going to, on the bottom, make a margin guide at 70 pixels from the bottom edge of the document. So I'm counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay.